Hello beautiful people, yeah, welcome back to the channel. I hope you are all doing well. In today's video, I want to share with you this salicylic acid and azealaic acid cream recipe. This cream is especially good for people with acne. So if you have acne, you have blemish, you have dark spots, this cream is a must for you. You're going to love it, especially for treating acne. So it's a very good recipe that I have tried making so many times, and the result is always amazing. So stay with me to see how I make this. And to get started with making my cream, I'm going to start by laying out my ingredients, and I am starting with my water-free ingredients. For this, I will start by adding in some allantoin into my clean beaker. I'm using allantoin in this recipe because allantoin has a moisturizing property to the skin. It helps with dryness, it soothes irritation, it also helps with little exfoliating and give the skin some hydration. So allantoin is a nice ingredient for this recipe. Then I will add in some EDTA. EDTA is a chelating agent that helps to prevent your skincare products from color changing, odor changing, pH jump. It makes your skincare products to be stable over a long period of time. Then I'm adding in some glycerin. Glycerin is an humectant that helps to hydrate the skin and draws in moisture into the skin. So it's a nice ingredient as well. Then I will add in my distilled water. Distilled water is a water that is good as well. It's the best water you can use in making your skincare products. So after adding in my distilled water, I am going to set my beaker aside. So these are all the ingredients I'm using in my water for this. The measurement for the ingredients is on the screen, so you can write that down in case you want to try out this formula. So I'll place that aside, then I get another beaker to lay out my oil phase. So for my oil phase, I'll start with my wax. This is silky wax. I'm using silky wax in this recipe. You can use ghee wax, you can use any other wax of your choice. Then I will add in some setyl alcohol. I love setyl alcohol in blood in my recipe. So I added my setyl alcohol into my beaker. Then I'll be using some oil. I don't really want to use so much oil in this recipe because of the anti-acne cream it is, so you don't need oil. So I'm just going to use about just small amount of oil, and I'm using sunflower oil. Sunflower oil is a very lightweight oil, so it makes it perfect for this recipe. You can decide not to even use oil at all, but I don't want to make it without oil. So this is my oil phase ingredients. So this is my oil phase ingredients. So I'm going to get a pot that I'll be using to dissolve my oil phase and my water phase. So I fill the pot with some water, and I'll place my two beaker in there. So I'll take this to my heat to double boil it until the two ingredients are dissolved. So while my ingredients are dissolving, I want us to talk about salicylic acid and azealaic acid. In these containers, I have salicylic acid in one container and I have azealaic acid in the other container. And in this recipe, I am using salicylic acid and azealaic acid at 2% each. So I'm using 2% salicylic acid and 2% azealaic acid in my recipe. So salicylic acid helps to treat acne. It helps to treat mild to severe acne, and it helps to prevent and reduce swelling, redness, unclog your pores, and help to shrink your pimples. So azealaic acid, on the other hand, helps to prevent future breakout. It helps to clean your pores from bacteria caused by acne, and it also helps to make your skin, like, remove the dark spot left by acne, even out your skin. And the two ingredients together are just an excellent duo. They work perfectly together. So salicylic acid and azealaic acid are very good to pair together in this our recipe. So the next thing I will do is we're going to dissolve our salicylic acid and azealaic acid. And to dissolve this, I'll be using some propandiol. Propandiol will act as my solvent to dissolve my salicylic acid. even though propandiol also has some other benefits, it's an emollient, it helps with softening the skin, it helps with as humectant as well, it works as an humectant as well. So I'll be using this propandiol to dissolve my salicylic acid and azelaic acid. The first one I added into the propandiol is my salicylic acid. Then I will add in my azelaic acid into the beaker as well. So I'll be dissolving the two ingredients at once. I'm going to, after adding that into my beaker, I will stir properly together. Then I will take this to the heat to dissolve the salicylic acid and azelaic acid until it is fully dissolved. So in this container, I have some sodium hydroxide solution. So this sodium hydroxide solution, I'll be using to raise the pH of my products later on, because salicylic acid has a very low pH and it can destabilize your product because of its pH. This thing. So we're going to use this to raise the pH of our products later on. Now my water phase and my oil phase is fully dissolved. I am going to pour in my oil into my water just as usual, and then we'll still blend this together thoroughly to give us an emulsion. After misting my emulsion for some time, I am going to leave my emulsion to completely cool down and thicken up. This is my salicylic acid and azelaic acid mixture that I went to dissolve. It is fully dissolved, and this is the solution we'll be using to make our cream. I'll just set it aside to cool down. Then I'll check on my emulsion to see if my emulsion is completely thickened off. At this point, it is thick, but it is still very, very hot. So I will allow this to cool down before I will start adding in the rest of my ingredients to my cream base. Now this is my emulsion. It is completely thickened up and it is cooled down. The next thing is to add in the rest of our ingredients into the base cream, and the first ingredient I'll be adding is the salicylic acid and azelaic acid solution. I'm going to pour the salicylic acid and azelaic acid solution into my base cream, and I'll stir this thoroughly together to combine. So at this point, you will notice that your base cream is looking watery. It will look as if your base cream is trying to separate, but it is not separating. This is the work of the salicylic acid on your cream. Salicylic acid has a very low pH, so when you pour that into your base cream, it will destabilize the pH of your base cream. And that is why I said I made a sodium hydroxide solution down, so that I can use my sodium hydroxide solution to raise the pH of my cream. So you just add in a few drops of your sodium hydroxide solution into your cream, and you're going to stir that thoroughly together, then you blend again, and your emulsion will come back again. So the first time I worked with salicylic acid, I actually threw away the cream because I thought I did not do it the right way. I thought my cream was bad. I did not know it was the salicylic acid that destabilized the emulsion. So later on, when I read more about salicylic acid and I do some more research, and I saw that I actually did the right thing, but it was the salicylic acid that destabilized my cream. So now I am trying to stick blend together, and you will see that our cream base will come back thickening up again. So this is the cream base. It has thickened back again, and the pH, this means that the pH has actually come up back again, because the salicylic acid drops the pH of the base cream. And this is my base cream. You can see now it is thick and it is okay. I'm still going to check the pH later on, but for now we are good. We can add in the rest of the ingredients into this base cream. So my first ingredient I'll measure out is my aloe vera extract. This is aloe extract, so you can use other extracts as well, but aloe vera extract is very nice. It has a soothing properties and other benefits as well. Then I will add in my tocopherol. I'm using alpha tocopherol. You can use your regular vitamin E oil, you can use D tocopherol, anyone, it's okay. Then I'll be using some essential oil. I'm not going to use fragrance oil in this recipe. This is because some people react to fragrance oil, so I don't really like using fragrance oil in formulation like this one. So I'm using essential oil. I used peppermint together with some, is it frankincense or lemon? I can't really remember, but I remember the peppermint, so it was two fragrance oil I combined together. After adding my fragrance oil, I added in my Dermal Plus preservative. Then I am going to mix my ingredients together thoroughly before we're going to be adding this into our base cream. I'm going to pour my cool down ingredients into my base cream and I will stir together thoroughly to combine. So you can use your stick blender to stick blend this again to make sure your ingredients are well combined, which I actually did that off the camera. So after mixing that properly, this is my cream. It is ready. At this point, the next thing to do is to check the pH of your cream. I adjusted the pH of this cream to a pH 4. Salicylic acid work between pH 3 to 4, while azelaic acid work between pH 4.5 to 6.5. So using pH 4 is the best because salicylic acid work very well at a lower pH. You can use pH 4.5 if you are using a pH meter, but I use a pH strip, so I use it at a pH 4. Then I get a clean container and I store in my salicylic acid cream into my container. So to use this cream, you are going to be using this cream at night. I would not advise you use this cream during the day because of its low pH. That's a very low pH. So I would advise you use this cream at night. And then you don't want to use this cream every day for a starter. You don't want to use it every day. You use every other day. You use today, you don't use the following day. You use like that. You can decide to be using this cream maybe 3 times a week. And once you see that your skin is well blended with this cream, your skin is okay with it, then you can start using every day. Thank you so much for watching. If you have watched this video to this point, thank you. I really appreciate you. If you have not yet subscribed to my channel, please do well to subscribe. I have a lot of amazing DIY skincare recipes on my channel. And if you're a returning subscriber, thank you for always coming to watch my videos. I really appreciate you. Please don't forget to like this video as well and leave your beautiful comment in the comment section. If you have any question at all, I'll be so glad to attend to them. Thank you for watching, and I hope to see you all in my next video.